You were both in Skull and Bones, the secret society.
It's so secret we can't talk about it.
What does that mean for America? The conspiracy theorists are going to go
wild. I'm sure they are. I don't know. I haven't seen the website.
Number 322?
I don't
even see. You're
going to lose? No, I'm not going to lose.
If you did, what would you do?
Well, I don't plan on losing. I've got a vision for what I want to do for the country. See, I know exactly where I want to lead.
Skull and Bones' only purpose is to get its members into positions of prominence around the world so that they can elevate other members to similar positions. That's it.
Secret societies have actively participated in the construction of the American governmental system. Freemasonry, to name just one society, left its imprint on the Declaration of Independence, the American Constitution, and on dozens of national symbols, from the Great Seal of the US to the dollar bill. This American passion for secrets, rituals, and exclusive clubs has been particularly strong in its universities, where the fraternity system was developed. The fraternities, or frats as they're most commonly referred to, are student associations with academic and philanthropic goals. However, they also abound in codes of silence and initiation rites, very similar to those found in Freemasonry and other secret societies. The first ever recorded frats with the Flat Hat Club and the Phi Beta Kappa, both founded at Yale University. Skull and Bones was founded in 1832. Its original name was the Eulogian Club. Its creator was a merchant named William Huntington Russell, owner of Russell & Company, a transport company which was rumored to smuggle opium into China during the Opium Wars. The name Skull and Bones probably comes from a curious tradition. During their meetings in the campus chapel at Yale, the society used to hang a skull and two crossed shin bones upon the door as a warning that they should not be disturbed. The society was also known as the Order of Death, Corporation Star, or simply The Order.
mean, are we being ruled by politicians who consult with Baphomets and demons?
Yes, we are. The way the world is structured is like a compartmentalized pyramid, and it's pyramids within pyramids. And so what the Illuminati do is they make sure that only their people, or those that are not a problem to them, will reach those levels of power in which decisions have to be made to push this agenda forward.
Skull and Bones membership certainly has its privileges. At least three American presidents were or are Bonesmen. George W. Bush, his father George H. Bush, and William Taft. The proposition that this small club of the well-to-do pulls the strings of American power, and through it those of the whole world, by placing its associates in key power positions, is supported by substantial evidence. The elections of 2004 saw the almost impossible come true. Both the Republican candidate George W. Bush and his Democrat rival John F. Kerry were members of Skull and Bones. That's to say, prior to running as representatives of parties that supposedly propound opposite political visions, they had both sworn allegiance to the same mysterious principles. And what's worse, they share secrets that are not known to their own constituents.